and let you know how excited we are to have these wonderful new folks who are going out into the world to make a huge difference in the lives of others. It's a real privilege to have you in the midst.
Family members and the students that are up here. So thank you for coming. I also want to thank the
our graduates are very special. And so I wanted to share a little bit about them with you. In our traditional nursing program, we have 67 graduates representing a number of states and even countries. Graduates are from Utah, California, Idaho, Nevada, Alaska, Montana, Minnesota, Illinois, Michigan, New York, Wisconsin, Maine, and Georgia. Countries represented include Turkmenistan, China, Korea, Russia, Mexico, Lebanon, and one student who grew up in India but has ancestors from Tibet. It's amazing that people from all over the United States and the world come to Westminster. Our graduates range in age from 21 years to 57 years and are 88% female and 12% male.
But most importantly, I know some of you are even asking yourself, do I actually know enough to be a nurse? Well, let me help you answer that one question. Yes, you were right. I know a lot of you are... But it sounds like I am, and I wrote our speeches together. So we did not. And for the last couple of weeks, the only thing that has been going through my mind, I'm a Lord of the Rings fan, is you shall not pass. Anyway, but here we are. So, yay, who's behind me? Anyway, I'm Jenny Butler, and I kind of wish I was facing the other way because these are who I want to speak to the most, my classmates. Anyway, the other evening, I was sitting in an awards assembly for my high school senior, and I realized something. The word amazing is quite possibly the most overused word ever. So, I will not be using that word to describe my classmates. And I'm sure Dr. Harrell will be grateful if I use correct grammar in both my speaking and writing. So, Dr. Harrell, you're welcome to look over my speech after I'm finished, and I expect you to pay attention. Graduating in 2 weeks. I have 5 children, 2 boys and 3 girls, 4 of which are sitting right back there with my husband. Where's the 5th, you say? Well, he graduated from high school last year and is currently in Russia and will be for about another year. I am immensely proud of my children. And as a side note, I wouldn't be so good at pediatric maternity and especially mental health nursing if it wasn't for them. As a surrogate mother of the class, I would often bring big bags of snacks and multiple bags of extra stuff for an occasional emergency, which earned me the title of mom in class. I like to bring fun things like Play-Doh or bubbles for my presentations, and I love that my classmates would say, "You're such a mom." Indeed, the toughest and most rewarding accomplishments of my life have been being a mother, both to my biological children and my classmates. And for my classmates' mothers and fathers who are not up here publicly to say how proud they are of you, I will say it. I'm so proud of you. You did it. The old African proverb, "It takes a village to raise a child," is precisely how we have gotten here today. The other day, as I was rummaging around in my overflowing purse / double bag, I came across a note from my dad, who passed away just this January. I don't know when it was written, but encouragement from our village often has a funny way of surfacing when we need it most. It read, "What a wonderful daughter and mother you are. You give so much love to your family and to us. We love you. You do it all. Thanks, Dad. I love you, too." Now I want you to think for a minute, just who is your village? Your parents, friends, children, other family, neighbors, teachers, mentors? You have been a part of the village as you have progressed through your childhood and into adulthood. You have been given by those around you strength and encouragement. You have been propped up when you have been slumping, celebrated when you were winning, and surrounded when you just couldn't go on. How many times this semester have you had a near meltdown and been told by Jill, it will all be okay? Or quietly assured by John as you walk into a test 15 minutes late because of the down snowstorm. It will work out, don't worry about it, just relax. I wish I had a John voice or a Jill voice, but I don't. Sometimes my village has been populated by patients during the clinical rotation who have had an impact on me. I spent 1 hour in an AA group during my mental health rotation and it changed my life forever. Mr. Adams, as I'll call him, was dying of liver failure. He had drugged himself to death and needed a liver transplant, but was told he had to be sober for at least 1 year before he could be put on the list. He was a father and husband and was very much a diminished individual. The only time he made eye contact with me with anyone in the group was to look me directly in the eye at the end of the meeting and say, just promise me that when I show up in your DR, you won't treat me or anyone in my circumstances like a second-class citizen. I promised him I wouldn't. And to Mr. Adams, wherever you are, thank you. To my classmates, it is our turn to become the village elders. We have spent many years learning and growing from our village, and yet you have not lived until you have done something for someone who can never repay you. That is, after all, why I believe we all chose nursing. The skills, techniques, and knowledge are only the beginning. How can we ever repay our village? Can we? To the professors, adjunct professors, and many other support staff, I thank you. Much of where I am today is because of you. To my classmates who listened to my family drama, shared my snacks, played with my Play-Doh, who bubbled with me, ate more cooking in a deli with me, I love you. I love you for who you are and who you are becoming. I will always cheer you on. I have been lucky enough to be a part of this last traditional cohort, and I couldn't have asked for a better experience. To my parents and siblings, thank you for listening to me, supporting me, and giving me the strength to go on. To my children, thank you for understanding and for somehow knowing my heart was torn every time I had to study, go to class, or spend time on another project. And I'm sorry I had to subject you to Dad's cooking. To my husband, who brilliantly managed to hold me and our family together for the last 4 years, I love you most. As a proud member of the Westminster College of Health Sciences 2018 graduating class, I pledge to carry that name with honor. Whether nursing is your beginning or your end, be bold, be confident, be brave and kind. Be generous and courageous. Become the leaders you were meant to be. Thank you.
Quality of the care of the client. I woke up to the sound of silence. The cars were cutting like knives in a fist fight. And I found you with a bottle of wine, your head in the curtains, and heart like the 4th of July. You swore and said we.